This is Adventist World Radio Ghana.
Voice of Hope.
AWR Ghana. Voice of Hope. Voice of
Hope. This is Daylight Magazine, and under this segment, we have Reflections,
Youth Corner,
and Moment of Truth.
I am Kwejo Ansedu, and I'm presenting this with
Hannah B. Nyakun.
How are you doing today, Hannah?
I'm doing well, and you?
I'm doing well as well. I hope, dear listener, you enjoy our programs. Stay tuned.
AWR Ghana, Voice of Hope. Voice of
Yesterday you were a baby, but so soon you are growing too. And before you know it, you've become a lady or a man with children too. Then your health and strength begin to fail you, and you say, now what shall I do? Because the days and years you may have wasted, maybe memories haunting you. So you see, my brother, that life is so short. It passes so quickly and soon it's gone. You just have one life to live on earth. So remember your creator while you have breath. So you see, my brother, that life is so short. Passes so quickly and soon it's gone. You just have one life to live on earth. So remember your creator while you have breath.
A mirror image. I hope you do. Come join me as we take a purposeful contemplation of our lives. This is the program Reflection.
Having the key of the abyss and a great chain in his hand, and he seized the dragon, the ancient serpent, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. He threw him into the abyss, locked it, and sealed it over him in order that he might not deceive the nations any more until the 1,000 years were finished. After these things, he must be released for a short time. Revelation 20, verses 1 to 3. Do the 1,000 years take place before or after the second coming of Jesus? Three major views have sought to answer this question. In the postmillennial approach, Jesus comes after 1,000 years of human progress. While popular in the 19th century, when education and scientific progress made many believe that the world was getting better, it doesn't. However, match the Bible's prediction that things will be very difficult before the end. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verses 8 to 12, 1 Timothy chapter 4 verses 1 to 5, Revelation 13 to 19. It also doesn't match the realities of today's world. The pre-millennial view regards the millennium at a literal 1,000 years after the second coming of Jesus. In the amillennial view, the millennium is not a literal period of 1,000 years, but a symbol for the whole Christian era from the cross to the second coming. The choice between these two may not make a huge difference from the devotional point of view. Our family pediatrician recently approached me with a fourth view of the millennium. He said, "I get a little tired of all these arguments about whether the millennium is pre or post. I've decided to develop a different approach." "What's that?" I asked. "I call it panmillennialism. That means everything will pan out in the end." A pediatrician's position may make a lot of sense. I believe, however, that John clearly intended the 1,000 years of our text to occur after the second coming. By the time the millennium begins, the characters such as Babylon and the beast have already passed off the scene. Revelation chapter 19. The beginning of the millennium also comes after the mark of the beast and the forced worship of the beast's image. Revelation chapter 13 verses 15 to 17. Revelation chapter 20 verses 4. So if the millennium begins with the cross, the amillennial position, the events of Revelation 13 to 17 would have to have occurred before the cross. But I am aware of no serious scholar of Revelation who interprets the book in its way. While I want to respect the kinds of theological arguments that godly people make for the amillennial concept, the position does not seem to flow from the narrative of Revelation itself. Today's devotion was from the book The Gospel from Patmos, written by John Pollen, and was read by myself, Richard Kwabena Anefi Jatin.
This segment is about the youth and their lives in today's world. The program is Youth Corner.
Aimlessly beneath the barren sky, leave it to me, I'll lead you home. So afraid that you will not be found, it won't be long before your sun goes down. Just leave it to me, I'll lead you home.
Welcome, friend, to the program Youth Corner. We are continuing our lecture on Transformed by Trouble. And we are looking at few points. Remember that God's plan is good. Okay, God's plan is good. And the next is rejoice and give thanks. The Bible tells us to give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. How is this possible? Notice that God tells us to give thanks in all circumstances, not for all circumstances. God doesn't expect you to be thankful for evil, for sin, for suffering, or for their painful consequences in the world. Instead, God wants us to thank Him that He will use our problems to fulfill His purposes. The Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. It doesn't say rejoice over your pain. That's a wrong conception. You rejoice in the Lord. No matter what's happening, you can rejoice in God's love. You can rejoice in His care. You can rejoice in His wisdom, His power, and His faithfulness. Jesus said, be full of joy at that time, because you have a great reward waiting for you in heaven. We can also rejoice in knowing that God is going through the pain with us. We do not serve a distant and detached God who sprouts encouraging cliches safely from the sideline. Instead, He centers, or He even enters into our suffering. Jesus did it in the incarnation, and His Spirit does it in us today. God will never leave us on our own. The next point is, refuse to give up. Be patient and persistent. The Bible says, let the process go on until your endurance is fully developed, and you will find that you have become men of mature character with no weak spots. Character building is a slow process. Whenever we try to avoid or escape the difficulties in life, we short-circuit the process delay, and we delay our growth, and we actually end up with a worse kind of pain. The worthless type that accompanies denial and avoidance. When you grasp the internal consequences of your character development, you will pray for fewer comfort me prayers. Help me feel good, and more comfort me in prayers. Use this to make me more like you is what you will pray for. You know you are maturing when you begin to see the hand of God in the random, baffling, and seemingly pointless circumstances of life. If you are facing trouble right now, don't ask, why me? Instead, what do you want me to learn? Then trust God and keep on doing what's right. You need to stick it out, staying with God's plan, so you will be there for the promised completion. Don't give up. Grow up. At this juncture, friend, I encourage you to keep the lively hope alive. God bless you. My name is Gemini G. Getty.
World Radio Ghana.
Voice of Hope.
AWR, Voice of Hope. We will bring you joy. Keep hope alive.
You can contact us on Adventist World Radio Ghana, Valley View University, P.O. Box AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or email us at awr@vvu.edu.gh. Or telephone us at 233-208-704-532.
cannot see, you light my way.
This is the moment of truth, where truth is presented with precision and exactness. Enjoy this encounter of a lifetime.
Calling for you and for me.
Calling for you and
see on the portals, he's waiting and watching. Watching for you.
I am glad once again to share the Word of God with you. Wherever you are, just pick your Bibles as we open the sacred pages before us this day. Let us invite God to lead us as we go through the Bible together. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for giving us the opportunity today to listen to your Word. We want to thank you that you have been talking to us. You have been encouraging us in our problems. You have been solving our problems for us. Today is another day. Father, talk to us. There are problems that are supposed to be solved. We pray that you will be with us. You will solve all our problems. Those who are sick, that you will heal them. Those who are confused, that you clear the confusion from their minds. Be with all of us. Bless us as we study your word together. For we pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Kindly turn your Bibles with me to the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. Let us hear the word of God. Therefore, I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, not about your body, what you shall put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? This was Jesus speaking. Jesus is saying, don't think about tomorrow. Only think about what you will eat today. And he is the one who created tomorrow. And he knows tomorrow. He knows what will happen to us. And he knows where we'll be tomorrow. And he will provide for us. At a time, the voice of the cross singing group sang, why worry when you can pray? Trusting in Jesus, and he will lead the way. Don't be like doubting Thomas. Just rest upon his promise. Why worry? Why worry when you can pray? This is a right observation. Some of us are getting worried too much. I want to encourage you to trust in Jesus. Just rest upon his promise. This is an age of worry. There are many things to trigger worry. Later, the body's resistance becomes weak. Sicknesses result. Medical experts tell us that too much worries and anxieties affect blood circulation, block the arteries, and cardiovascular diseases may result. In other words, Jesus is not saying that we should not express concern over our lives. That would be a careless, ascetic life. He is not recommending that we be poor to be acceptable to him. He is not saying that we should not plan our lives. He is against unnecessary worry, especially on material wealth. Much worry is a manifestation of faithlessness. When we have a Jesus that has power to all problems, only him knows how to handle the problems of about over 6 billion people on this planet Earth. In moments of tension and crisis, he should be the first person to contact through prayer. Tell him when you left all these problems at the foot of the cross. He who has given you life knows your need of food to sustain it. He who created the body is not unmindful of your need of raiment, will not he who has bestowed the greatest gift on us also provide for our needs? I quote from this. The sparrow falls without his care. No soul bows low, but Jesus knows. For he is with us everywhere and makes each bitter tear that flows. And he will never, never forsake the soul that trusts him. Amen. Trust from the Mount of Blessing, page 95. Jesus says, don't worry. Don't think about tomorrow. Don't think about what you will eat. Don't think about material wealth. All you need to do is to leave your worries at his feet. Because the God who created the body and put the blood, created the veins, knows that the body needs food to survive. Look at the birds in the field. Look at the grass. Jesus says, if this grass is well protected, is well clothed, and is being fed, which will appear for just a little while and then vanishes, how much more we who are called his children? Are we no more better than the grass or the birds that fly in the air? Yes, we are. Why won't he provide for us? My brother, my sister, don't think about tomorrow. God will take care of tomorrow. Don't think about the future. He will take care of the future. Make your plans, but leave them at the feet of Jesus. Tell him, this is my plan for the future. Take care, and the Lord will make it work at his own time. I want you to understand that we serve a God that is powerful, a God that is mighty, a God that is strong, that at the mere mention of the name Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. If we have such a God, why are you so gloomy? Why are you so discouraged? Why are you comfortless? Why are you doubting him? Just trust him. Just believe in him. Just know that Jesus can make a difference. I know he can make a difference. I know Jesus can make a difference. He has done it. When Peter met Jesus, he became a new person. When Mary Magdalene met Jesus, she became a different person. When you meet Jesus with your problems, he will turn them upside down. Satan is a specialist in giving us problems, but God is the greatest specialist in solving all our problems for us. Why worry? Why are you confused? Why are you discouraged? Why are you downhearted? That same Jesus that opened the Red Sea before the people of Israel is here with me. The same Jesus is here. I feel his presence. Jesus is here. He wants to talk to you. When Satan begins to mess around us, I want you to understand that God will begin to bless around us. The same God is here this time, and I want you to live your life in his hands. You will never be disappointed. Jesus is here. What are you doing with him? What are you doing with Jesus, the Christ, the Messiah, the Savior? Jesus is here. I want to pray with you this time to just stretch forth your hands and tell him, Jesus, I want you to take my hands and help me to walk with you day by day. Teach me how to take a step after you, a step after the other. Help me to learn how to walk with you because I'm a little child. The same Jesus is here. Wherever you are, just bow down your heads as you seek God in prayer. Dear Father, we want to thank you once again. We want to bless your name for this wonderful mercy you've given to us. Dear Lord, take control of our lives. Help us to walk with you. Help us to abide with you. Help us to know you. Help us to believe in your word. Take control of our lives. Your listeners are in your care. Wherever they are, Jesus, be with them. Bless their families. Bless their work. Bless whatever they do in lives. That at the end, the glory be given to your holy name. Thank you, because we prayed with faith in Jesus' name. Amen. I am Pastor Akawusa Dennis Elisha, AWR, Ghana. Oh.
This is our address. Adventist World Radio Ghana, Valley View University, P.O. Box, AF 595, Adenta, Accra, Ghana, West Africa. Or you can email us at awr@vvu.edu.gh. You can contact us on telephone using this number, 233-208-704-532. I am blessed being a part of this program. Hannah, what about you?
The same here.
So I believe, listener, you did too. This has been once again Kwejo and Senedu and
Hannah B. Nyaku.
God bless you.